The National Aeronautics and Space Administration, or NASA, is preparing to say goodbye to its old but iconic Douglas DC-8. NASA has operated the Douglas quadjet for decades, first taking it in February 1986 and using it ever since as a flying science laboratory. The aircraft set to replace it? A Boeing 777. Even the DC-8 wasn't exactly new when it arrived at NASA. The jet was originally delivered to Alitalia in 1969 and flying with Braniff from 1979 until 1986. For NASA, it was flown under registration November 817 November Alpha and is used to collect data for a range of experiments on behalf of the world scientific community, with operations costing scientists approximately $6,500 per hour. The DC-872 is now approaching 54 years old, and despite being meticulously maintained by NASA, she is reaching the end of her unconventional life. As such, the administration has lined up a replacement for the jet. NASA's new Boeing 777 isn't really that new at all. The aircraft is actually nearly 20 years old, having first rolled off the production line in April 2003. The aircraft was delivered to Japan Airlines, who flew it under registration number Juliet Alpha 704 Juliet, from then right through to July 2020. Perhaps a victim of the pandemic, the 777's final revenue flight was from Sapporo to Tokyo on May 29, 2020. After a few weeks standing at Tokyo's Haneda Airport, it was ferried out to Victorville for storage on July 1st. There it remained until NASA decided to take it on. On December 15, 2022, the 777 took on the US registration of November 774 Lima Golf and was moved from Victorville to Langley Air Force Base. There it has been undergoing modification at the NASA Langley Research Center. According to the Dutch Aviation Society, NASA's budgets suggest the administration acquired the 777 at a cost of under $30 million. This budget would likely include the costs involved in the heavy modification of the jet required to turn it into a flying research lab worthy of taking the place of its iconic DC-8. It's all change at NASA, with the administration recently sunsetting its Boeing 747SP known as SOFIA, the Stratospheric Observatory for Infrared Astronomy. SOFIA has found a new home at Arizona's Pima Air and Space Museum. With the DC-8 also set for retirement, hopes are high that it'll see a similar fate rather than wasting away in an airplane graveyard somewhere. The DC-8 is fast becoming a rare breed in terms of aircraft still flying. Just three airplanes are listed as being in active service today. It'll be a sad day when the DC-8 finally leaves NASA's care. However, the extensive modifications and testing of the 777 could take several months, even years, and so the DC-8 could still be seen working for NASA for some time to come. Do you think the 777 was a good choice to replace the DC-8? Let us know by leaving a comment. In addition to our daily YouTube videos, Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com.